Oh man, I can't wait to get to the gym and get on the elliptical. Okay, time to go to the gym and get on the elliptical. Okay, I guess I'll go to the gym and get on the elliptical. Hi, yes, I'd like a large pepperoni pizza with extra cheese. Yeah, that delivery window's totally fine. I don't have anywhere to be.
I'm trying to film a video on motivation, but the only thing I feel like doing right now is staying in bed, and that's it. Ugh. Okay, time to get moving and do this video.
Much better. Hello, lovely humans, and welcome back to my channel. For those of you guys who are new here, my name's Heather. I am a baker turned physical therapy student, a cat enthusiast, and a woman who is on an adventure to lose 100 pounds and to get healthy. And when I say get healthy, I don't just mean lose weight. Health encompasses a lot of stuff. There's of course your physical health, but your mental health, your emotional health, and your spiritual health are really important too. And I also know how freaking frustrating it is when you feel like you are working your buns off and things just aren't changing. So, since we are all in this together, I thought I would tell you guys 5 things that you can do to make the weight loss portion of getting healthy a little bit easier, especially if you have been feeling stuck or just not motivated at all. Because y'all, I know the struggle, okay? You're not alone. So the very first thing you can do is to not eat in the car. It sounds really basic, and that's because it is, but the reasoning behind this, just bear with me and I'll walk you through it. So for me at least, eating in the car is usually associated with shame eating. Like, if I am out and about and I'm having a fierce craving for something, I know that I can zip through the drive-thru or run into a store real quick, buy it, eat it in the car, hide the evidence somewhere in the trash can afterwards, and no one will be the wiser. So over the years, I got in the habit of eating in my car a lot because most of my eating habits were absolute, well, crap. Anytime I snacked on something, if it was in the car, I felt like crap about it afterwards. When you're trying to get healthy, you definitely want to have a good relationship with food. You want it to be something where you can cherish your food, enjoy it, and make it a really nice experience. For a lot of us, our relationship with food is terrible. We're emotional eaters, you know, we're upset, we're stressed, we're super happy and we want to snack on something. There's always an excuse to eat food, but we're never really doing it for the experience or the enjoyment of the food itself. So, if you want to enjoy your food, a car is not really a good place to do that. When I realized that I was doing all of my like naughty eating in the car, I was like, oh, okay, maybe I should just cut the car out of the equation. So now if I want something, I take a second and I'm like, okay, do I just want this because I'm in my car and I know that I can inhale this at the speed of light and no one will ever know? Or do I actually want this? And if I actually want it, I can get it, take it home, and actually be intentional about sitting down to enjoy my meal or my snack. A lot of weight loss is changing our mindset about how we experience food or exercise or really anything in the realm of being healthy. When you're not thinking about it, you're gonna consume most of the time a lot more calories than you would intend to. You're really not going to be enjoying that food or paying attention to if you even want all of it or not. And chances are, you might have some regrets with that. That's number one. So, for number two, that requires a slight vacation, but not really, because we're just going to my fridge.
Welcome to the dark side. No, I'm just kidding. Welcome to my fridge.
All right, so the big change of my fridge is courtesy of a TikTok video.
These top three shelves are not as important. That is mostly just all of my meal prep related stuff for the week. The change that I made is in these three drawers. If you'll notice, there's a ton of condiments, a ton of jelly baking related supplies. Basically anything and everything that is canned or bottled is now in the drawers, rather than the normal fruits and vegetables. Here is where I put my normal fruits and vegetables, as well as other snacks. I wanted in my fridge, the very first thing I see, to be healthy snacks, excluding the butter, of course, that's just where that fits. We have low-fat cheese sticks and some Baby Bells. We got apples, plums, oranges, and strawberries. And as we continue down the line, there's more healthy options. I've got my grapefruit, my applesauce, my yogurt, carrots, any sort of veggies I can get my hands on, my protein shakes for the morning, milk just happens to fit there, and some extra veggies for me to eat. So you might be wondering why on earth I decided to spend an entire freaking day scrubbing the bejesus out of my fridge for hours, only to move a few things around to a few different shelves. Here's why. I really, really love sugar. And anytime I'm feeling a little peckish or I'm feeling a little bit hungry, I'm prone to go and rummage through the fridge and see what I can find. And you know what is the most forgotten thing in my fridge that goes bad without fail? Every single week, it's every single one of the fruits and veggies that I buy. Why? Because they're in a drawer in the bottom of the fridge. No one ever looks at that forgotten bottom drawer of vegetables. So I decided to make it a little easier on myself, because the whole point is that weight loss is hard enough. We don't need to make it any harder on ourselves. I wanted to make it so that instead of seeing random snacky looking foods on those first three shelves, I wanted to only have already prepped meals or ingredients for meals on those first three shelves so that I wouldn't be tempted to grab any of it unless I was having an actual meal. And instead of just having a bunch of condiments that I kind of just forget about on the door, I decided to put all of my fruits and veggies front and center. Because that way, when I open my fridge, the first thing that I can go to is basically like my snack section, but it's not an unhealthy snack section. If you notice when you were looking at all the stuff on my door, it's all bright because, you know, fruits and veggies are, and that helps. So it's eye-catching. And it's also a place where I can go and not be tempted by a bunch of random junk. So of course, part of this also means, you know, don't buy the random junk. But if you give yourself the opportunity to open that door to your fridge and the first thing you see is things that are appetizing with color, so they're popping out at you, and they're stuff that tastes good, you're gonna be more likely to just grab the healthy food rather than going for something junky. So if you're struggling with the way you think, find a way to trick yourself, and that's basically what I'm doing. Find fruits and veggies that you actually get excited about. Because remember, the whole point, sustainable habits, changing your mindset with food, and falling in love with food and the experience of eating in a way that's healthy. We've covered all the diet-related things. What's next? Now, let's talk about exercise. Now, most of you know by now that while exercise is important, diet is definitely the most important part of weight loss, but exercise is definitely something you should be doing, not just for weight loss, but for your physical health. It helps your heart, it helps your lungs, it helps a whole lot of stuff. Now, at this point, especially with the whole pandemic going on, I know that a lot of us have been either working from home or doing school from home. And I've noticed that a lot of us also have clothing storage. Wait a minute, that's not right. That's better. Now, a lot of us have treadmills. As you can see, even the cats are fascinated by them. Now, for those of you who have been working from home and are lucky enough to have a treadmill, you've probably noticed somewhere along the line that when you work from home, you don't get a lot of steps in. And when you're done working, you're kind of pooped and you might tend to, you know, sit on your butt and watch TV for a while. So when you're feeling super unmotivated, there's a really, really easy fix for that. Literally all you have to do is get a piece of wood and put it across the arms of your treadmill. You don't have to do it all day long, but for at least a little while during the day, you can put your laptop on top of that board and get some steps in while you are doing your job or while you're doing schoolwork. And if you don't work from home, when you come home, you can put some YouTube on there and watch my videos while doing your walk.
And yes, I am not so ridiculous as to think that every person in the world has their very own treadmill. I have these guys who keep me running around all over the place. But for those of you guys who are working from a desk but don't have a treadmill, there's a very easy fix, and you can usually find them somewhere in between $20 and $30. They have mini versions of stationary bikes that you can prop underneath your desk and get your pedals in while you are working. If that's not an option for you because you are still going to work or going to school in person, on your lunch break, you can go for a walk. Whenever you're not feeling motivated, exercise really does help, because even if you're not in the mood for it, exercise gives you endorphins. Endorphins make you happy, and y'all know the quote, happy people just don't shoot their husbands. They just don't. So go out and get those endorphins, and you might actually start to feel a little bit more motivated. And you know what? All this talk about being active has got me wanting to move.
Okay, so it is windy as all heck outside, so I don't know how well this video is gonna go, but I will try. So my fourth tip is to make yourself take just 5 minutes to do whatever it is that you are having no motivation for whatsoever. So you don't wanna go to the gym? Okay, go for a walk for 5 minutes around your neighborhood. Set a timer. Because here's the thing, don't let social media fool you. No one is motivated 24/7. Ooh. Everyone in America does not wake up stoked as all heck to go to the gym or to eat healthy food. Life is far from perfect, and there's gonna be a lot of days that throw you off track of your diet or your exercise routine, whichever. But if you set your timer for just 5 minutes and force yourself to do that thing that you don't wanna do for just 5 minutes, one, you can feel accomplished, because frankly, 5 minutes is a whole lot better than 0 minutes. And chances are you're gonna end up doing it for more than 5 minutes anyway, because the hardest part is just starting. You can also apply the 5 minute rule to your cravings. So if you're like, okay, I really want a brownie, but I know that is not in my allotted calories right now, you can set a timer for 5 minutes and be like, you know what? If I still want it in 5 minutes, I'll revisit and say, okay, maybe I should have this. Or for the 5 minutes, you can be like, oh, my craving's gone. Chances are 5 minutes from now, you won't be craving it anywhere near as much. And if you are, but you know that you just cannot have it today, you can set another timer for another 5 minutes and be like, maybe I just need another 5 minutes to get over this craving. Either way, if you use this rule on a regular basis, it can make a huge difference over time.
Okay, now that I'm back and successfully looking like a windblown chipmunk, I can give you my fifth, why am I holding up 10 hands, my fifth tip or trick, whatever you want to call it, for making weight loss a little bit easier, especially when you're not feeling motivated. When you are burnt out or tired or stressed, it gets so much harder to actually stick with everything that you put in place to make yourself successful. So when you are stressed or tired or just not motivated, it's a lot harder to stay on track with your diet and your exercise. And one thing that I really just want to suggest to you guys to make it a little bit easier is to plan ahead for your snacks. And when I'm talking about snacks, I'm referring to the healthy snacks, not the carb-laden heavenliness that we all want to snack on. But if you plan ahead, it'll make your life a lot easier. For me, the thing I struggle with the most is my commute, because it's an hour and a half for me to get home from school Monday through Friday, and it's usually right around dinner time. And y'all should know that this girl gets hangry. Like, if I'm trapped in a car for an hour and a half and I'm hungry, heads are going to roll. I'm going to need a snack, or I'm going to end up caving and going through the drive-thru, eating it in my car at the speed of light, not being satisfied, and honestly being kind of mad at myself, because it means that not only did I not have a healthy snack, I probably wrecked my appetite for dinner and my calories for the day, or possibly the week, depending on how hangry I was feeling. So plan ahead. If you know you're going to be in the car forever, you should be able to stash something in your glove box. Preferably something that won't melt. Stash a protein bar in your glove box. Bring some carrot sticks with you. Throw them in your backpack. Throw them in your briefcase. Obviously in a bag, we're not trying to have a carrot avalanche situation. But do something ahead of time so that you don't end up starving, snacking, and frustrated. Because it's gonna be so much easier to not cave and get whatever food is tempting you or just conveniently nearby if you already have something ahead of time that's prepared. Just make something that is at least moderately healthy and filling so you don't have to suffer. Because kind of like the whole 5 minutes thing before, if you spend 5 minutes planning ahead, you can save yourself tons and tons of calories and agony. So those are my five tips. I know even if we're all on a journey to lose weight, it's a completely different journey, so feel free to pick and choose whatever works for you, but hopefully at least one of those is something that can make your life a little bit easier. Don't forget that being healthy is not just about the numbers on a scale. Take it one step at a time, and don't forget that it's okay to love your body every step of the way. You don't have to wait until you hit your goal weight to think that you're a worthwhile person, because the truth is, you're worth it. So, if you guys like this video, make sure to leave a like down below and to subscribe. That way you can learn more tips and tricks for being healthy, but also see how I'm doing with my entire journey because I'm documenting the entire thing on YouTube. So hit that button and I will see you lovely humans next Friday. Bye bye.